The differences in scenario at the care institutions of both countries can be attributed to their history of evolution. The recreation center scheme in India was introduced in early 90s in northern India. In retrospect to West, most of the recreation centers do not have assisted programs. A number of people visiting these centers is also very less. According to my study, only 20% visited these centers regularly due to various factors like lack of awareness, restricted mobility, as requisite transport facility system was not available to bring them to these centers, and the elderly did not find the recreation activities interesting enough, and the activities were not facilitated to be organized at a common time. So the elderly could not come together to socialize with each other. Moreover, the geographical spread of these centers is uneven, and the number of centers is also very less to cater to the needs of the rising elderly population. In some cases, few of the recreation centers have now closed operations, as very few elderly avail the services. Lot of elderly and their family members I interacted with said that they are not even aware that there is a recreation center in the neighborhood.
Wow.
So the pertinent need is to raise awareness regarding these centers by involving resident welfare associations, advertising them in newspapers, local media. And the kind of programs and activities need a modification too, which I will be talking late in the later part of the webinar. Coming to old age home, till a decade back, India and many countries of Asia had rooted traditional joint family systems, where the elders were being cared off by the younger generations of their family, most commonly by the sons. So the concept of old age home was in the infancy stage. In India, the first old age home was established in the early 19th century in retrospect to USA, whose history dates back to 17th century, where the concept of poor houses, which are the charity homes for poor, became very popular, which were then replaced by board and care homes. These are the licensed 24-hour care property, often within someone's personal home, providing the basic levels of care and needs. These homes were then converted into something more public and permanent that was state and federally funded. From this, by 1965, resident care homes or nursing homes were a solid fixture.